What's up, guys? My name is JayvynStudios FTW, and today, while looking at the ever-increasing downward spiral that is the Captain Marvel marketing and a continuation of journalists and SJWs all over the media white knighting to the ends of time, I've been doing a lot of thinking. What kind of mindset does Brie Larson has? What makes her act this way, and why? Does she really believe the things that she says? Is it her philosophy? And is she in the right to spread her ideologies all over the fan base? Today I want to talk about the feminist mindset and how a group of feminists with power can be detrimental to any and pretty much every type of entertainment medium. First things first, what is feminism? If you Google it, Google will tell you that it's the advocacy of women's rights on the basis of the equality of the sexes. But I more prefer the Wikipedia definition. Feminism is a wide range of political movements, ideologies, and social movements that share a common goal to achieve equality amongst both sexes, including educational and professional opportunities. So in my words, feminism is supposed to be an advocate movement for women to have the same social and professional opportunities, which means working the same jobs, doing the same tasks, and being recognized as much as men are in certain fields. Equality is the goal here, or so I thought. The ideas of feminism first popped up at the height of the French Revolutionary War in 1792, when a woman named Mary Wollstonecraft wrote a book titled The Vindication of Rights of Women, and in that book is the exact same ideologies and beliefs in modern feminism today. I'm not making it up. In her book, Mary writes about the patriarchal society and its way of limiting women's rights for professional and societal opportunities. But to my understanding, the first feminist movement didn't happen until the early 19th century with women's suffrage, creating certain events in Seneca Falls, opening up a dialogue about the social, civil, and religious status of women back then. The main goal of the entire movement was to give women the right to vote. And it took almost the entire century for women to gain the right to vote. It wasn't until the turn of the 20th century, and even then, several decades later, it wasn't before the rights were fully obtained and used. Then things became a gray area. The feminist movement had one goal, and that goal had been achieved. But then what would it come next? Many did not want to focus on another issue because they knew how long the process would take. Feminism is often described as the longest war. This is solely because it is trying to change the mental mindset of modern society. It wasn't until the mid-1900s that feminism sprang into action again. Specifically for the political parties, they targeted the Democrat Party and made such progress in the following years. Today's modern feminism is very strange, confused, and at times downright toxic to anything and everything it touches. Modern feminism at the heart is still wanting equal rights to men. However, it doesn't have a clear goal like it did before. Many feminists today also harken back to Mary's novel from the late 1700s. Again, many feminists harken back to Mary's novel from the late 1700s, which, okay, it was a new idea back then, but now in 2019, it's not so much a new idea anymore. If anything, feminism has fallen from a constructive cultural progression movement to a raging political garbage fire. In the late 1990s, feminism was deemed as political correctness, which made it an enemy and thus began the culture war. I don't mean to suggest that all feminists are raging political correctness pieces of garbage. Certainly, we should remember that conservatives back then caused many feminists to be woke. There's a cause and effect on every action conservatives and liberals make. Whenever a side push forward, the opposite pushes back, creating massive divisions within the communities they serve. I'm not a doctor here or anything. I'm pretty sure that the modern feminists like Brie Larson has something mentally wrong with them. Feminism has no longer become a political profession. It is now a personal thing. Feminism has become part of their identity. And look at how they're acting. Long, toxic, disgusting arguments online about cons of our culture. Most of them are kids who don't even fact check or know what they're talking about. They've gone from facts like in the late 1800s to feelings and things that are more reliable than a professional year-long study. So when you get in a heated debate with them, their brains explode and they succumb to confirmation bias. Confirmation bias is the tendency to search for, interpret, favor, and recall information in a way that confirms one's pre-existing beliefs or hypotheses. It is a type of cognitive bias and a systematic error of inductive reasoning. The effect is strong for emotionally charged issues and for deeply entrenched beliefs. Basically, when people say entrenched beliefs, that's religion, country, culture, and politics. Also, it means the person has apophenia. Apophenia is the spontaneous perception of connections and meaningfulness of unrelated phenomena. The term was coined by a German neurologist and psychiatrist, Claus Conrad, from 1905 to 1961. Like, for example, when Doom Eternal, a video game made by id Software and published by Bethesda, was criticized for somehow discriminating illegal immigrants last year with their game. Yeah, just let that sink in. Or maybe a better example, when people criticized Soulja Boy last year for charging people off a Chinese ripoff console, he said it was because he was black. The guy is a total idiot, in my opinion. I know all of that sounded confusing. Trust me, it boggles the mind too. So to get to my point, a lot of today's feminists have that type of mental issue. They've grown in it and spreading it to various platforms and fan bases and communities. It is very clear that it's undesired. I'm not saying feminism is diseased. I'm saying that it comes with a mental disorder. That disorder is confirmation bias and apophenia. Brie Larson has apophenia, and it is very confirmation bias. She brought the culture war onto Marvel fanbase, and we are seeing the effects of it right now. The movie comes out in less than a week from now, and at this point, the damage is already done. People have made up in their minds. They are avoiding Captain Marvel like the plague and going elsewhere with their money. Brie Larson, I hope you seek serious help after this. This is JayvynStudios signing out. Have a good one.